In late 2015, the nations of the world came together in Paris and agreed to limit greenhouse gas production in order to keep global temperatures below 2 degrees centigrade. And I want to see the Paris Accord take place and be successful. But if we fail, I think our future holds no reason for optimism. If we get to 4 degrees centigrade of warming, we're talking about over 30% of all species on the planet facing extinction. And we're currently on path to reach 4.5 degrees centigrade by the end of this century. 2 more degrees beyond that, 6 degrees centigrade, eliminates the possibility of plankton in the ocean undergoing photosynthesis. Every third breath you take is given to you by photosynthesis of phytoplankton in the ocean. In other words, we're on track next century to decrease the amount of oxygen available for this planet to breathe. We're facing global suffocation. Now that just sounds ridiculous. And it's hard to imagine that that's in our future. But if we fail to successfully achieve the Paris Accord and keep our global temperatures below 2 degrees C, we're looking at a failure of the planet. Throughout my career, I've studied paleoclimate, which is the patterns of climate change, specifically in my case, over the last 500,000 years or so, which to a geologist is a relatively recent period of Earth history. And over this period of time, we know that climate has gone through a series of ice ages and warm periods, and we're currently living in the most recent warm period. It's on the order of 10,000 years long. It has led to the development of agriculture, domestication of animals, the production of crops, the evolution from hunter-gatherer societies to cities. So there's a natural climate cycle. There is what we now know is modern anthropogenic climate change driven by human production of carbon into the atmosphere. I think what it will take for people to get it is for them to be directly impacted by climate change in a way that they can't chalk it off to some other process. And yet, even if it smacks us in the face, humans are so naturally adaptable and we are so naturally resilient that as the world changes, we respond to those changes and continue to sort of operate on a brush fire basis, dealing with the issues of the day, the stresses of the day, and not thinking too much about the distant future, even though the negative impacts of the distant future are hitting us right now, day in and day out. We need to adapt our agricultural systems. We need to adapt how we live along the shoreline. We need to adapt how we manage ecosystems. Lots of different activities that human society is engaged with need to study and to incorporate climate adaptation into how they operate. I'm very fearful that one of the things that make us strongest, which is optimism and adaptability, is going to do us in the end. It's going to be a different world. Wherever we can, let's make it a better world.